Good morning, students. Yesterday we have done one passage of lesson 1.2, Dick Whittington and his cat. So how the scene passages come for 10 marks. So today we are going to do again one passage, second passage, okay, from the same lesson. So it will be a practice for you to solve the question answers. Okay, so directly the question answers will not come. Now it will be in the form of a passage. You have to read the passage once or twice and then you will solve the question answers. Okay? So the passage 2. Passage B. Yesterday we have done A. So today it will be passage B. And passage B will be from page number 6 and 7. Okay? That is 6 and 7 page number. 6 and 7 page number, it will continue. So, passage will be formed by chance to up to as equal. Okay? By chance. From there to as he could. Okay? This is our B passage. Now, again, we will have the questions in the form of B1. So the first question, as I told you, for 2 marks, it will be fill in the blanks or complete the following statement. So that will be from the passage, very easy. So you can score your 2 marks very easily. So that is fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks. First A. So you have to write this passage A. Dick has fallen in front, then you will have to fill up, okay, and make it clear the answer. Dick has fallen in front, dash. The next sentence, that is a fill in the blanks. Dick was given a dash and dash. So this is fill in the blanks for 2 marks. Now second, again the second question is of answer the first. Okay, and these answers you will also get it. You will get it from the passage itself. Okay. So this answer you will get it from the passage. A. You have to read the passage. You have to read the passage once or twice. Then only you will get the answer. So how did Mr. Fitzwarren favor it? How do you? Mr. Fitzwarren favor B. Okay, this question is of 2 marks, so you will get 2 questions there. Now the second question B. See the second question now B. What difficulties did they did they have to face at Mr. Fitzwarren's house. Okay, this will be your second question. Again, the third question, that is the vocabulary. Okay, you will get it. Find the words from the passage. Okay, find words from the passage Okay, now the meanings will be given and you have to find the word from the passage. Find words from the passage which means, okay, and you will be given the meaning of the words and you have to find out the words there. Okay, the first one, suppose a very small room. Okay, this is one. Second one, you will be getting the question. Okay, a very small room. Then the second question is, that is, that here and there. Okay. So the third one, that is the vocabulary, that is also from the passage only you will get these questions. Okay. So you have to read the passage once or twice before writing the answers. Okay. Now, be free after be clean. Before, that is a grammar question yesterday we have done it before. That is do as done. Okay. Do as directed, you can get it from the passage itself, the sentence you will get it. You will get the sentence from the passage itself. So this is your grammar question now. Yes. So he solved the problem. Okay, suppose the sentence is he solved the problem. Okay. Now here, we write the sentence. Beginning with, beginning with, so you will get it, the problem. You will get this sentence. Okay, directly it will not be asked change the words. It will be asked rewrite the sentence beginning with. So when we read this question, we come to know that if we start the sentence with the problem, means it is change the words. Okay, then we have to understand. Now second question you might get it. Okay. He slept in. He write it in past continuous tense. Okay, so you will get these two questions, these types of questions you may get it. Okay, this each question will carry one. And in the end, as yesterday we have done it, that is a personal response. Okay. Personal response questions. Okay. Personal response. So personal response means the question will directly asked to you. Your opinions are given the importance. Okay. So you have to give your opinion on that personal response. Yes. Now listen here, the personal response question. What do you come to know about Mr. Fitzwarren? Okay. What do you come to know about Mr. Fitzwarren? Is what is your opinion after reading the passage about Mr. Fitzwarren? Okay. So these types of questions are there in the passage too. Now listen here. We are going to discuss the question answers of this passage. Okay. The first one, fill in the blanks, that you can do it very easily. Second, question answers are there. Okay. How did Mr. Fitzwarren favor Dick? How did Mr. when he saw Dick there, he gave him the work in his house and also gave him the living place and the food to eat. So that was a favor done by Mr. Fitzwarren. Okay. Next question, what difficulties did Dick have to face at Mr. Fitzwarren's house? So two difficulties were there. Okay, the two difficulties were, first one, in his sleeping room, there are many rats and mice. He couldn't sleep properly there. Okay, and the second one of, was of the cook. The second difficulty was of the cook. She was very harsh with Dick. She used to scold Dick many times. Okay, so this was the two difficulties there which he has to face. And the third one, now already the question is there, P3. Okay, five words from the passage which means small room. That is, in the passage, if you read it properly, go through with the passage, you will find out there is a attic. Attic word is there. Okay, so that is a small room below the roofing slope. It is there. Ran here and there. So when you will go through with the rats and the mice, that paragraph, you will see that the rats and the mice scampered. Scampered means ran here and there. Okay, that is the B3 question. Okay, then next one. Now listen here, whenever you solve the grammar question, okay, whenever you solve the grammar question, you will write down the question and their answer. Otherwise, from the passages, you don't have to write the question. Just give the marking properly, B4, B3, A or B. Okay, that you will give it properly. But B4 grammar question, you will write the question as well. Please solve the problem. Now this sentence, it is in the simple past tense. So when you will change it into passive voice, means you will start a sentence with the problem. So it will be, the problem was solved by him. The problem was solved by him because the sentence, it is a simple past tense. Okay. Now, next sentence, he slept in. Okay, this is simple past tense and you have to change it into past continuous tense. Okay. Past continuous tense. Now, listen here, this sentence, past continuous tense. In past continuous tense, we use two auxiliary verbs, was and where, and main verb, that is in the fourth form, that is a present participle, that is a ing form. Okay, so here we will use it as he is singular, subject is singular, so he was sleeping in. Okay, that will be the past continuous tense. Now personal response, what do you come to know about Mr. Ferrars? Okay, Mr. Fitzwarren. So you can write it from this passage, I come to know that Mr. Fitzwarren is a kind and a generous person. He gave not only a living room to Dick, but also gave him food and asked him to do some work. Okay, so this, he is a kind and generous and a helping nature person. You can also write by your own, helping nature. He is a very generous person, kind person. He cared for the children and he has love for the poor people. In this way, you can write it and you can express your views. So that question is also of 2 marks. Yesterday also we have done the same thing, the passage 1. And today also we have done the same thing, passage 2. Now listen here, there is one more problem. Whenever the tense is asked, okay, when the tense is asked. So at that time, see the question here that we have written. We write the sentence in past continuous tense. So instead of that, we will ask, state the time and aspect of the time and aspect of the sentence. Okay. Instead of this, now this question will come, time and aspect. Now, what does the time and aspect mean? Time means, that is the tense itself. Okay. So tense itself, it is tense. We write the sentence in past continuous tense. This question directly will not be asked. Now it has little bit changed. Okay, the pattern of asking a question has little bit changed. So here you will ask, state the time and aspect. So what you have to write in the answer, time, that is the sentence, it is in past tense. Okay, time is the past tense. Okay, in the past. Then aspect, you have to write it. Aspect, which form of the past tense? That is continuous tense. Okay, suppose it is, you have to change. And you have to ask here. So it is in the past tense. Now listen here. It is not in the continuous. This sentence, it is not in the continuous form. It is in the simple past tense. So aspect will be simple. Means it is in simple past tense. Okay. So these type of question may be also asked for the tenses. Or otherwise, you write the sentence in past continuous, present continuous, or future perfect. Any other tense can be asked here. But now, little bit changes are there. So they can ask, giving a sentence, after giving a sentence, they can ask you, state the time and aspect of the sentence. So time is the past tense. an aspect, that is the simple aspect means the type. Aspect is the type. So there is little bit modifications in asking a question, so you don't get confused. If it is directly not asked, rewrite the sentence in future perfect or present perfect, then this type of question will be asked. Time is the name of the tense. Present, past or future, that is the time, and aspect means the type. Okay, so that is very simple about this. Okay, so this second passage today we have done it. Now listen here, yesterday I told you about the degrees of comparison. We have done some words about the degrees of comparison. So now in 8th standard, not the degrees of comparison, words will come to you, but the sentences are there. How to change the sentences, that will be there. So there are three rules to change the sentences from one degrees of comparison to other. So today we are going to discuss only one thing about it. So today we will discuss only one rule, that is degrees of comparison. So in this lesson you got in those degrees of comparison. So in 8th standard in high school, you won't be asked there only to change the words. The sentences will be given to you. Okay. According to rule 1, we will look at, seeing the example, we will do the sentences. Suppose it is Rita is the cleverest girl in the class. Okay. Now here we are talking only about the Rita, but we are talking about the group. In the group, class means a group of the students. Okay, Rita is the cleverest. Here the, it is given there before the superlative degree. So this sentence, it is in superlative degree. Okay, superlative degree. Okay, this sentence is in superlative degree. Now it is in rule 1, only the, we are talking about the Rita. Rita is the cleverest among all the girls. Okay, that is here. So now this sentence, we have to change it into comparative degree. So Rita is cleverer than any other girl in the class. Okay. So when we are talking only about the Rita, so Rita is the cleverest one. Okay. But when we are changing it into comparative degree, the will not be there, it will change into cleverer than any other will be used. Okay. Than any other girl in the class. So this is our comparative degree. Okay. So we have changed this sentence into from comparative degree from superlative degree. So Rita is cleverer than any other girl in the class. Okay. Now positive degree. Okay. No other girl in the class is as clever as Rita. So now we have changed this into positive degree. Okay, we have used here no other. So without changing the meaning, we have changed this sentence from superlative to comparative and from there to positive. Okay, without changing the meaning of the sentence. Okay, so without any, Rita is the cleverest girl in the class, that is superlative degree. And then Rita is cleverer than any other. Whenever there is the, we are talking only about the Rita. So at that time, than any other is used in the comparative degree, and the, we will take out the there. Okay, this article will not be used there in the comparative degree. And in the positive degree, no other word in the class is as clever as Rita. So this is our rule 1. Tomorrow we are going to do rule 2. And rule 3. Okay. Yes. So we have done two passages of lesson 1.2. Okay. So read the lesson properly for solving all the passages there. Okay. We'll meet you.